Welcome to our TeamGuru video tutorial. Today we are going to learn how to create a new metric. So let's get started. Please go to your metric dashboards module on the left side and from the menu choose metrics. Here you will see the list of already existing metrics, and to create the new one please click green plus button. And now we are ready to define our metric. Under Basic Settings tab, you will first select your group that your metric belongs to, and you will choose it from the submenu. Those are already existing groups. In case a new group needs to be created, it will be created under Metric Dashboards and Metric Groups, but you have to have a sufficient role to be able to do that, and usually your system administrators are going to be the ones who are setting it up. Then you will choose the title of your metric that will be displayed in your dashboard. You can add labels if you need to. Data type, you will choose if it's number, percentage, date, and so on. I will choose number. And now you see that you can enable units conversion, which means that you can view and enter metric values in units you prefer. Some of your locations might be collecting data in different units of measure, and you are able to set this up. And how to do that, please check our other video tutorial for enable units conversion. Next, you can choose your scale from the options in the submenu. You can also select your unit, for example, dollar sign. Type is very important because it drives automatic color coding of your metric values in the dashboard. Positive means that it is good to be above the plan. Negative means the opposite, it is good to be below the plan. You can also set up additional restriction security for your metrics, and values of a restricted metric will be accessible only to users with special rights to see the data for selected org units when you tick this box. Next, protect metric. Here you can protect your metric settings when you tick this box. You can also lock actual plan or forecast values, and from the submenu you will choose the time period. Metric administrators, here you will choose user or several users, even user groups. And these administrators are the only ones who can change the settings of your metric and also enter values for the locked fields. You are able to set up exception to the rule under settings by org units, but we'll talk about it later. And now we are moving on to optional advanced settings. Under metric full name, you can explain any abbreviation used in the metric title, such as OTTR, and it means on time to request. Definition, here you can add any details for your metric, such as how it is calculated, if there are any limitations, and so on. You are also able to add related documents, and you can either add existing ones from the system, or you can create the new one. Here I would like to point out that you are also able to add external link to your metric. Next, you have to select metric definition owner and choose user from the submenu. Color coding priority, here you will either select forecast or plan values, and these values will determine the cell's color coding. You can also customize your cell width, and here you will be selecting calculations for your year-to-date, quarter-to-date, month-to-date, and week-to-date data, and also full year, and you will choose from the options in the submenu. You can also set up minimum and maximum possible values and default number of decimal places, which will be shown in your dashboard when using this metric. Here you will set up how to assign weeks to month and choose from the submenu. Under Rollup, you will be setting up automatic calculation of your weekly, monthly, quarterly, and annual values. Rollup function, from the submenu, you will choose the calculation. Once you select any calculation, you will see that you have another option that you have to choose calendar type, either calendar month or fiscal month. Here, I would like to point out, calendar month rollup can be used for daily or monthly data only. If you collect data weekly, you have to roll up your monthly values according to fiscal calendar. If fiscal calendar is not used in your company, you have to choose the option calendar month and enter both weekly and monthly data manually without system calculations. Fiscal month, if you choose, it will be driven by your format as selected right here. And the next is calculated metric. When you set up calculated metric, metric values will be automatically calculated from other input metrics using custom formula. Here you will select which values you want to calculate, either actual plan forecast values or just actual. And here you will be setting up your formula. It can be a simple formula such as A plus B, but we also have a full list of advanced functions. Please visit our website to view this list. And in case you need help to build formula, please don't hesitate to contact us. And when you start building your formula, you will see that system and color coding navigates you through what is the next step that needs to be set up. You are also able to set up offset time period. Please use default view in case input metrics don't have values entered and it is not possible to calculate the formula without the value. You will be also able to customize your formula to your needs. And once again, if you need any help, please don't hesitate to contact us. And you can also test the calculation. And once you are done with your basic settings, please save it. And now let's go to our second tab, More Settings. Here you will be able to list org units for which data will not be collected. If you don't want to collect metrics values for a certain org unit in your company, in that case, you can select this org unit right here. And if you are using combination of this org unit and metric in any dashboard, the field will be grayed out. And you can do the same for your projects or partners. Calculation priority. The default setup is that the system takes values from formula calculation first, then summary and roll up, but you are able to customize it for your metric too, and you just have to drag and drop. We can also create custom fields for your metric, and if we do, then you will see these custom fields displayed right here. And the next step is settings by org units. Under settings by org units, you will be able to set up specific lockout period for individual org unit and time interval. And this is regarding the basic settings when I was talking about locking the values and that you are able to set up exception to that rule. And this is it. So you are able to add individual rights. You can choose your org units, projects or partners. You are able to include subfolders. Administrators are the ones that they will be able to enter the values for this locked metric. And here you will be setting up the rule if it applies to only daily values, weekly, monthly, quarterly, years, or all of them. You can just customize it to your needs. Here you will be setting up time, a lock time period. In case this lock time period is different than by metric default, this period needs to be more strict than the one that is in the basic settings. And next, calculation priority by organization units. You are actually able to override this default calculation priority for your metric for specific org units. So you can choose any org unit and change the calculation priority the same way. And the last step, usage overview. Here you will see the list of all the documents that this metric is used in. And in case you make any modifications to your metric, all these documents will be affected by this change. And once again, once you are done with your settings, you just click save and return. And here is the list of our metrics. If you need to modify your metric, you have to click this edit pencil and make changes. You can search your metric using the search window. You can also use our filters. There is also advanced filter. You are able to export your metrics into an Excel file. And if you have a sufficient role, usually only system administrators can do that, you will be able to use show mass actions functionality. And I would like to show you one more thing before we finish today, and it is how you can add metric, create new metric directly from your dashboard. And when you go to your dashboard and to its settings, under dashboard setup, you will be adding metrics to your dashboard. And here you have an option to either choose already existing metric from the submenu, or you create a new metric when you click on this green plus button. And this is pretty much it. If you have any questions or need any assistance, please don't hesitate to contact us at support@teamguru.com. We would be very happy to hear from you.